Hi everyone, in this eventy video we're going to talk about product types. Maintenance, upgrade, base, what are the different types of software license you can buy, how are they handled in eventy neuron suspended intelligence, and why it is important to set this value correctly. Before we get started, a quick warning. This video is talking about licenses generically. It is important to check the specific terms of your contracts and licenses. Different vendors may use different terms for the same thing and may even use the same term to mean something different, so make sure you check. Also, in this video, we are mainly interested in how the different types of license affect your software entitlements. Your licenses may also provide other benefits, such as access to support or training. We're not interested in those in this video, other than to point out that it's important to check for these sorts of things and make use of them when they are offered. When you create a transaction in Evanti Neurons for Spend Intelligence, you enter a vendor and SKU code. And if those values match an item in the Evanti SKU library, the other fields are completed for you. However, new software titles and versions are being created all the time, so the transaction you are creating might not be found in the SKU library. In this instance, you need to populate the fields yourself, including the product type. This field is particularly important, as it affects how Evanti Neuron Suspend Intelligence reports your entitlements. In this video, we're going to look at the options available to you in the product type list, which are the same as those in the product type column of the generic transaction spreadsheet, if you are importing your transactions that way. The value you choose for product type is important because it sets the values that appear on the licensee's data grid, which you use when determining your software entitlements. There is a separate video about determining your software entitlements using Evanti Neuron Suspend Intelligence. I'll put a link in the description. The first item in the list is Undefined. This is the default. The system needs to have a value set, and undefined means you can quickly identify that at best this value is a guess. It is handled the same way as the next value, which is license. License corresponds to a single entitlement for a specific version of a specific software title and adds one to the base column on the licensee's data grid. This entitlement lasts forever and is sometimes called a perpetual or evergreen license. If you buy a license for Vantosi version 3, you can use Vantosi version 3 forever. Typically, but remember to check, you can upgrade to new minor versions or dot versions from version 3 to 3.1, 3.2 and so on, and install patches, but you are not allowed to upgrade to version 4. If you want the freedom to upgrade to version 4, you need a maintenance license. You usually need to have bought maintenance at the same time as the base license, which is what the license and the maintenance option is for. Maintenance licenses expire and you need to renew them, which is when you actually choose maintenance rather than license and maintenance. Maintenance adds one to either active maintenance or expired maintenance on the license's data grid. License and maintenance adds one to a maintenance column and to the base column. Typically, you need to make sure there is no gap in your maintenance agreements or the maintenance becomes invalid. You also need to ensure that there is a base license for each maintenance license. If your maintenance has expired or you never had maintenance and you want to upgrade to a newer version, then you need an upgrade license, or upgrade and maintenance if you want to avoid buying upgrades in future. Upgrade adds one to the upgrades column. If you have signed up to a subscription to a cloud application, such as Microsoft 365 or Adobe Creative Cloud, you choose subscription, which adds one to the subscriptions column. Subscriptions are valid only for the duration of the subscription. The final option is not a license, which is provided to enable you to record transactions that do not correspond to an entitlement that you want to track. There could be a number of reasons for this. For example, you may have software installed on computers where you can't track the usage, and so you don't want to track the matching entitlement. If you record the entitlement but don't see a usage, you could inadvertently allocate the entitlement to a second liability, which would be wrong. I hope you found this video useful and it's helped you to understand the different types of software license available and how to complete the new transaction dialogue and generic transaction spreadsheet correctly. Thanks for watching.